very young age that jumping out of trees was a bad idea, and I had largely avoided the practice until my recent trip to the White Mountains. An import from Latin America, zipline courses are springing up across the Northeast as ski towns look for ways to extend their season. The premise of the sport is simple. In fact, gravity takes care of most of it. You just string up a wire between two trees on different parts of a mountain, attach a person to that wire with a pulley, then convince them to jump. At Alpine Adventures in Lincoln, New Hampshire, the convincing starts as soon as you get out of the car. You're greeted with strains of Eye of the Tiger, and as the staff fits you with a harness, they do it with the jubilant enthusiasm of a high school pep rally. Then is the short bus trip to Barren Mountain, where you make your ascent in an ancient Swiss troop transport. They try to build a bumpy ride as part of the adventure, but getting tossed around the back of the truck feels a bit like being a tennis shoe in a dryer, and it's the only part of the trip where your helmet will come in handy. Soon you unload at the top of the mountain, and the guides lead you through a treetop village of platforms and Burma bridges. They stop at a thin aluminum wire arcing down through the trees, and you realize they expect you to get on that thing. The guides keep the mood light as they clip you on, checking and rechecking the connections, cracking jokes and talking about anything but what might happen if they do it wrong. Then they ask you to stand up on the railing and, when they say so, push off. My leg doesn't so much push off as crumble beneath me, but it's enough to launch me into space. There's a moment of free fall, then the harness firms up beneath me and I'm riding the wire. The pulley lets out a loud hum as the trees flash by on either side. I look down and see the ground coming up from below. The landing is faster than I expect, and my feet don't keep up. I stumble a few steps, then fall softly into the moist earth. As I pull myself up, I can't stop laughing. Word has gotten around about the thrill of ziplining, and Alpine Adventures is attracting tourists from all over, sometimes booking up weeks in advance. Jacqueline Bretz came with her family, all the way from Maryland.
So did you enjoy it?
Yeah.
Was it what you expected?
Not really, but it was better.
Uh-huh. What were you expecting?
I was expecting more like just like straight across. You go across and you go across again and all. Mm-hmm. And this is more like swinging, flying. It was fun.
Alpine Adventures was the first course to open in New England, and they still have bragging rights as being the longest, highest, and fastest around. Their Skyrider course features 5 jumps that zigzag across a valley. The longest stretch is a quarter of a mile, and takes you well above the tree canopy, some 200 feet in the air. But that might just be the tip of the iceberg. With more and more courses opening every year, you can bet on seeing even longer and faster jumps in the future, as companies try and keep up with the tourists' thirst for thrills.
It was great.
How'd you guys like that one?
Loved it.
Awesome.
Yeah.
You need more. You need another one.
Yeah.
Bigger, higher, longer, faster.
It's one of those things that you'll never do.